Welcome to Water Wisdom, sponsored by waterfilters.net. I'm your host, Aquaman, and we're back again today to focus on the GE Merlin. What you're seeing right here next to me is the most highly advanced, technologically superior reverse osmosis system for the residents available today. It has a number of really great features. Let's see if I can list them. For starters, it is a tankless system. You won't find any other RO system that is tankless. That means what you see here is all it is. It fits underneath your kitchen sink or perhaps even under your bathroom sink without taking up a huge amount of space. You're probably familiar with that propane-sized looking tank that many RO systems have. Some of them are, you know, like this big. You don't have to worry about that with the Merlin. It is the only RO system available for the residents that has two membranes. Extra low energy, high efficiency membranes, something never before accomplished with residential RO. And it has two of them, so it's capable of producing water on demand to the tap without producing water ahead of time. That's why it doesn't need the storage tank. In the green environment that we're living in nowadays and the awareness that people are having of that, the best wastewater to good water ratio available on the market, 2-to-1. Every other system is going to be at least 4-to-1, and many systems are 5-to-1. That means is for every gallon of good, pure, ultra-pure reverse osmosis water the Merlin makes, it only wastes 2 gallons. Other systems waste 4 gallons and many 5 gallons for every 1 gallon made. It is also capable of producing a massive amount of that water. 750 to 1,000 gallons per day can be produced by this system. The Merlin is super easy to install. It has all quick connect fittings. If you're not familiar with those, that's a friction fit fitting. No wrenches, no screwing together with Teflon tape and plumber's putty and all that. No, just stick the water line in the fitting, friction fit, done, moving on. Super easy to install. Basically, the only plumbing necessary for this system is the installation of the supply valve from the main water supply. You can see here we have the supply valve plumbed into our copper water line. There's an on-off shut-off valve here with that quick connect fitting that I mentioned earlier. The supply line comes down, comes into the system. We have this pressure gauge here because it is vitally important that your Merlin have a minimum of 40 psi on the supply side, and 50 is better. In fact, upwards of 90, it would be great, but 40 is the bare minimum. You've got to have that for the Merlin to work. There are booster pumps available for those who have well water situations or whatever the case may be, and you're just not quite at that 40 psi level. So the water comes in and it enters the stage one pre-filter. It's basically a high-end carbon filter. It's removing chlorine, hydrogen sulfide, and various other contaminants, some VOCs, but its main duty really is to protect the vital component, which is stage two and stage three, here and here, which are the membranes. Membranes are allergic to certain contaminants, and if not protected from those contaminants, their efficiency will fall off the charts rapidly, making the system produce really just regular tap water, even though you have these fancy, expensive membranes in here. So the carbon filter is really, really an important component and needs to be changed every 6 months like clockwork, no matter how much you use the system. So then the water goes in out of the pre-filter and into stage two and also into stage three, where we have the dual membranes that make it possible for it to produce water on demand. And then the reject water, and it's rejecting 2 gallons for every 1 gallon it makes because there's a lot of garbage in the water that it's rejecting, that goes to the drain. And then the final place that the water goes is out through this polishing carbon filter to just give it one last brush through carbon, and then we send it to the faucet. Now in our case, we split the line and we're sending it, and you can't see where it goes here, but it goes through this wall behind me into our kitchen area where it goes to a multi-use faucet and a dedicated reverse osmosis faucet. You could send one line to the refrigerator, for example, for your ice making. It's important that you check and make sure that your refrigerator does not have metal or copper water lines, because reverse osmosis water is so pure that it is also a highly aggressive solvent, and it's really only appropriate for plastic tubing, that is, if your refrigerator has plastic tubing. really important point there. So we send it through these two water lines into our kitchen area, and that's where we drink it. And it's great water. I love this water. I drink a lot of this water. It tastes great. It has no odor, virtually no taste, and it is ultra, ultra pure water. I don't have to sweat any contaminants. 95%+ of everything is removed from the water with this RO system. It is great stuff. My name's Aquaman, and this is Water Wisdom, sponsored by waterfilters.net. Thanks.